Jeff, I did not know you were in the adult industry before dog training until today, but it explains
a lot. Yeah, I talk about the dog industry all the dog industry, the adult industry all the time for 15 years. Best place for sexy gifts 15 years in a row. Miko Exotic Wear, look it up. And man, it gets used against me, but I used to tour the world. I had a multi-million dollar business. I used to actually speak at universities. I used to teach classes. I got paid by Brown University to teach a class. But I took an idea. Literally, I took an idea and turned it into a multi-million dollar business. And I was the first importer of silicone toys to the United States. And if anybody knows anything about the industry or about sex toys, you'll know that you don't want to be using that jelly latex stuff, because that just, your mucous membranes, vaginally and anally, just suck that shit up. And boy, is that bad for you. So silicone sex toys, which are great because you can boil them in water. But anyway, that's for another show. I've done whole shows on that. So anyway, let's jump right in. Hey, we're live. How's everybody going? How's everybody doing?
Stopping by to give thanks. Continuing education for dog owners and trainers is mandatory. Grateful.
Awesome. Dogs just stop doing bad shit. It's incredible. And then you get to start training your dog. Okay. So this is the What Would Jeff Do show. And it's a 60-minute show. We run from 7 o'clock to 8 o'clock. And we do it every Monday, Wednesday, and Friday. And you ask questions. You type questions, Joe will ask them, I'll answer them. You'll notice a lot of the questions, if you go through the feed, are like how to stop stuff. A lot of the dogs that come in here, ironically, Joel just came from the training room, stopping a dog from being a total jerk in its crate, going after another dog that was its neighbor. So how do you stop? So you'll notice that we use the word punishment or intolerable consequence or correction. Call it what you want. We also talk about the utilization of tools. The only way to stop an unwanted behavior is the opposite of a reward. So we can call it what you want to call it. Mm-hmm. But a lot of people, I think, are convinced that you can reward your dog out of bad behavior, and by giving it a punisher or a correction or even saying no to the dog. Mm-hmm. Like, you literally say no to your dog, you're destroying the relationship.
Right.
Like, that's what they're convinced. And if you do it before 6 months, you're fucked.
Yeah.
You might as well, you're fucked. You know, the dog's going to turn on you one day, mm-hmm. you know. And then we do a seminar series, jeffgellmanseminars.com, going on the road next weekend. We've got three coming up. And go to that website, jeffgellmanseminars.com, to see the schedule. And then we also have got the full training center here, which we're doing 24/7, 365, constantly working with dogs. So I just, I taped another WWJD Goes Deep today. I did that towards the end of the day. And we've got another man in the arena. Probably won't film that till sometimes next week, but I just wrote some notes. I got some real, really good one I'm going to do, I think. It's just getting people to think. Like, realistic situations that happen here, but think about, like, what you would do. What you would do. And then, because we just want to educate people and help people, because just because they're here, that doesn't mean that folks aren't dealing with the same stuff at home. And a lot of you out there that are like, we all struggle with dogs here. Like, how many times do we get to sit down and brainstorm like how to get to a dog? You know, so like, we also struggle too with dogs. They're dogs. So there's also something called Top Chat, which is only available on YouTube, isn't it? Mm-hmm. Only available on YouTube. Called Top Chat or Super Chat. A lot of people like to give their questions to the top of the queue. You know, we get over 100 questions a show. I usually don't get through them all. Sometimes I like to pontificate. But here we go. So after Joel, go ahead.
It's fine.
No, take a sip of water. I'll keep talking.
Kathy V says, hey, everyone.
Hey.
Brianna, Jeff, I did not know you were in the adult industry before dog training until today, but it explains a
lot. Yeah, I talk about the dog industry all the time for 15 years. Best place for sexy gifts 15 years in a row. Miko Exotic Wear, look it up. And man, it gets used against me, but I used to tour the world. I had a multi-million dollar business. I used to actually speak at universities. I used to teach classes. I got paid by Brown University to teach a class. I took an idea. Literally, I took an idea and turned it into a multi-million dollar business. And I was the first importer of silicone toys to the United States. And if anybody knows anything about the industry or about sex toys, you'll know that you don't want to be using that jelly latex stuff, because that just, your mucous membranes vaginally and anally just suck that shit up, and boy, is that bad for you. So silicone sex toys, which are great because you can boil them in water. But anyway, that's for another show. I've done whole shows on that. So anyway, let's jump right in.
Gretchen, hi guys, what a week. Wrong time to not stay on top of my water. Show attire for today and yesterday is long sleeve cotton plaid shirts and jeans while it's 80 plus out. I spent all day wrestling feral meat goats for a visually impaired kid. Joelle, you should try 4-H if you're so into fitness. Walking feral animals is a full body workout. You probably wouldn't like cows using you as a tissue, though.
No, you wouldn't. That's probably pretty gross.
Literally, that doesn't interest
me. That means sneezing at you, right? Yeah. Could you imagine cow snot?
I can't.
That's got to be a huge stain. Huge.
I like farm animals, but I don't want to work with them.
You like baby goats.
Yeah, because they're not like dirty and smelly yet. They're just like clean.
But you like baby goats named after you, too. Mm-hmm. Those are the best kind. Next.
Melissa said, good evening, all.
Hey, Melissa.
Shayla, thank you, Jeff, for responding to my reward-only question earlier today. I appreciate the free content you're always putting out. I will continue to watch and learn.
Yeah, oh yeah, no problem at all. I get hundreds of questions a day. Some I can answer if they're short. Some I say, do a one-on-one consult. And, if someone is just, again, it's like, guys, so many of you are struggling out there and so many of you are getting false information and you cannot stop an unwanted behavior with a reward only. But meanwhile, I heard you clicker training a dog today. Mm-hmm. It's like we clicker train and food train every dog on this property, even the aggressive ones. But you've got to understand how to stop unwanted behaviors. Next.
Brianna, also my uncle gifted me a new to me car today, a 04 Volvo XC90, an upgrade from my 97 Suburban. My dog is going to enjoy the working rear AC.
Nice. Hey, at least you had AC. That's nice.
Julie, do dogs do better with a companion dog? My puppy is 6 months old and my other dog just passed away.
That's personal choice. First of all, I wouldn't get one now. I'd wait till a year old and I'd wait till your dog is fully trained and you got a handle on that dog. Number one. That would be my advice. But could you imagine owning one dog? I mean, I can just open up the door and let one of your dogs run away if you want, But
are you kidding me?
Could you imagine owning one dog?
Probably not. Sometimes it sounds nice, but I like having a pack.
Yeah, I can't imagine owning one dog, but I've never acquired like them. Probably so close at a time. It also depends on you. It depends on your lifestyle.
I did just have one at one point. Right. Nice.
That's
true.
That's true.
It's pretty easy.
It also depends on your lifestyle, your budget. I mean, things are expensive. It's pricey owning a dog. It's pricey. Next.
Kathy, what kind of squirt bottle or squirt gun did you use? I can't remember what it was.
We used a squirt bottle. Did we get those from the Target dollar section?
Like the travel section, yeah.
Yeah, the travel section. Ooh, that's what it was.
One.
Yeah, you go to the travel section, you want to have all like the little toothpastes and little deodorants, little bottles for hair conditioner and stuff. Well, they have the little squirt bottles, one of those. Because they fit like just
right in your tree pouch.
Right in your tree pouch. It's not this big, huge thing. Next.
Vincenza, hi Jeff and Joelle. I can't make it to the seminar in Mantua next week. Like I hope I could have, but I have a question. My 9-month Cane Corso Enzo gets overly excited when he sees other dogs. Do I shock him once the excited behavior begins?
Well, it's not about shocking him. What you need to do is, first of all, you should do some baseline training. You apply, and people are like, oh, some people might say, oh, but it's just excitement. He's friendly. He wants to say hi. I still don't want a Corso getting excited, running over to me. It's like, my dog is friendly. It's like, but it's a huge Corso, and with cow snot coming out of its nose. So the first sign that your dog gets aroused, you would apply the punisher. Yes. Next.
Michael, hey, J&J, I'm bringing in a 2-month-old puppy to my house soon. How can I introduce the puppy to my 1-year-old Pomsky?
Well, that should be easy. It's a Pomsky. Just if the Pomsky does anything wrong, just like pick it up with some tweezers and toss it, So, I don't know anything about you, your skill set, the Pomsky. All I would say is work on existence. Some dogs make better puppy raisers than others. Other dogs are a pain in the ass. So if you're a little Pomsky, it becomes a pain in the ass, correct the Pomsky. Next.
Melissa posted the link to your Patreon channel.
Thank you.
Alona.
The Patreon channel is a source of information. It's awesome. It is got access to its own Q&A. And also it does, we do Zoom meetings next.
And our whole DIY playlist is on there.
Yeah, that's true. Next. That's Alona, very true.
How do I get my dog to be more rebalanced?
So I'm not sure what rebalance means, but if you mean by how do you get your dog to be more balanced, I mean, just work your dog. It's a process. I mean, you work your dog. You get your dog to do what you want, stop doing what you don't want, proper exercise, proper nutrition. Be careful about its excitement levels. Have a structured routine. I mean, there's a lot of different variables to that. Next.
Garcia family, my e-collar came today, and it is the first time that he, my 4.5-month-old GWP, is sleeping well in his crate. Thank you so much.
Nice.
But besides at night, he sleeps well than you.
Yeah, so I think it's important that people understand that the remote collar is not just for, and it's not the Garcia family like shocked the dog into submission that made the dog like go to sleep. It's like we had a conversation that probably calmed the dog down in the crate because the dog was probably a jerk in the crate. And the dog just went, I'll just hang out. Next.
Rochelle, hello. Do you have any dry kibble recommendations? We have a 6-month-old GSD, grain free.
I don't know any of any good kibbles at all. Now that Nestle bought up like the two Canadian kibbles that were decent. Kibble is not that great, but you know, you can talk to, you know, I mean, I feed raw. I would look into raw next.
Eric, hey guys, I have a 10-week-old puppy who plays with the older pup great, except when wrestling. He nips and pulls skin. Is this something older pup will correct, or should I, and how?
Number one, it's called normal behavior. So the dog is doing everything normal. If it bothers the other dog, it'll correct it. If the other dog is constantly running away from it to avoid the pup, then you got to correct it. But that's just normal. It just like that's what dogs do. Next.
Joe. Hey, J&J, my 3 GSDs have calmed down when it comes to the cattle. Still more work ahead.
Yeah, it's always work. With 3 dogs, you got the pack mentality, too.
Alona, how would I get my dog to come 100% of the time with a prong?
Well, 100% of the time is asking a lot. I mean, that means literally it never, never fails. I don't know if there is 100%. You know, it's like it never fails. But get a video. First of all, I would highly encourage you to get a remote collar. I would highly encourage you to get a remote collar because you're going to have a lot more leverage. It works at a distance. It can work, override your normal distractions, but dogs can blow through distractions. But we've got a video on recall training on our website, on our YouTube channel, but also there's a lot of videos out there on a YouTube channel. But the issue is you have to get to the point where when the dog doesn't listen, there's a consequence for not listening. That'll involve a long line and your prong. Next.
Kathy B., an intact billy goat is the stinkiest thing I've ever been around. Right up there with the dog's anal glands. That's exactly why I'm not interested in that lifestyle.
Nice.
Randy, hello, Jeff and Joelle.
Hey, Randy, how are you?
Gretchen, no, it doesn't stain, but my steer grabbed my mask and almost ate it. Half went into his mouth, but I couldn't get a new mask because it was late to go into the ring, so I had to wear it.
That's disgusting.
Gretchen said, I want to have a pack one day, but I'm not eager for all that meal prep. No thanks. I'd rather shoot an animal and let them have at it.
That's one way to do it.
Richard gave you a thumbs up.
Oh, thanks, Richard.
Melina, hi, guys. How do you feel about dog parks?
So, Melina, welcome to the show. Okay, I will let the audience answer that one next.
Roddy says, hey guys, huge love to you. Hope you're well.
Hey, Roddy, hope everything's okay over there in the UK and you guys are staying safe.
Kara, I'm discovering my blue Dane might be a little human aggressive. I try to do the spatial pressure exercise with him and he won't move. He will lay down and start to growl.
Yep.
If I dial up on the e-collar, he escalates. Yep. Corrected for marking on a walk and he barked at me. I was advised to muzzle condition and ask you about it. How do I continue? Also try to break the dog of separation anxiety from the other Dane in the house. Dog drools and shakes when the dog isn't in the room, correcting early before.
Okay. There's a lot of, you've got a lot of questions here. A real lot of questions, too many for me to answer on my podcast. But what I can tell you is for your spatial pressure exercise, muzzle up the dog. And instead of using the remote collar to move the dog out of the way, use leash pressure and your body to move the dog out of the way. Start out with that. The thing is, when you start, if it's really funny. I just did a...
It's a Great Dane, though. That's going to be hard. You might need another person.
And I need... What you could... Is it a Great Dane?
Yeah, my blue Dane.
Oh, the Dane. Yeah. So what you're going to do is get somebody else with a long line connected to the prong collar that's on the opposite side of you. So when you walk into the dog, they can help pull the dog away. Because some dogs are really, really stoic and they can just sit there and they'll just take the correction. Mm-hmm. They'll just take it. They'll be like, okay. But also, I just put up a what would Jeff do goes deep, and it really talked about owners thinking they've got great dogs. But once they start asking a lot of their dog, they find out the true colors of their dogs. So you're finding out the true color of the dogs. Well, how old is the dog? Does it say?
Mm-mm.
Okay. I mean, if it's at the 9 month to 12 month age, it's also coming into maturity. 18 months is coming into full maturity. And you're going to start getting a little bit more of that next.
Melanie, I corrected Lucky. Next day he saw a biker and just looked at me. What do I do? He went into a double down. Do I need to be giving him some command, heel or down when those really reactive triggers come by? I say no, but he doesn't know what to do next.
Exactly. So this is the thing. Who is that? Melanie?
Mm-hmm.
So Melanie, you know, I've talked about this many times. You actually have to teach your dog what to do after a correction. Now, it sounds like that dog self-corrected, though, right? Like she didn't.
Yeah, it went into a double down.
I mean, but I mean, it looked and then it looked away.
Right.
Yeah, so it self-corrected. So you actually have to teach the dog what to do. So to me, if you had a biker going by and your dog used to be reactive to bikers, you would just keep healing the dog.
Mm-hmm.
Keep the key is a lot of the times is movement. Next.
Sue, can a dog be autistic? My 15-month-old freaks at strange things. Not all cars when we're walking, but some cars. Lights on the wall at night from cars going by. Not loud noises, but whistling. And now we treated the yard for fleas, and the smell has him freaked that he won't go in the backyard.
So they do have a good sense of smell. So I don't know if a dog can be autistic or not. Chances are your dog is not. How would I know that? Because I don't know if a dog can or cannot. And here I am giving you my opinion on it. But there are absolutely dogs that don't seem to connect the dots as well and are a little bit off on the learning curve, the learning spectrum. But we get dogs in here that are afraid of like everything, right? Like, I mean, you've seen some really weird stuff on walks with dogs,
mm-hmm.
like dogs that are just irrational,
mm-hmm.
irrational, like, or one day they walk by a construction site just fine. And the next day they go by it and they totally freak out.
Yep.
It's like, we were here yesterday or even a morning and an afternoon walk,
mm-hmm.
you know? So I think there are dogs that struggle, but remember, just find the crack, find the weakness and work on it. Next.
Lauren, we're fostering a dog for a young lady in rehab for the next couple of months. The pit mix is very well behaved until any mail comes to our door or on our property. Mm. He then goes berserk and bit a delivery man last week. I've purchased the e-collar, but I'm not sure where to start. Any suggestions would be greatly appreciated. By the way, he's no longer allowed outside unless leashed and muzzled.
So, Lauren, thank you for leashing and muzzling your biting dog, because as I keep saying this over and over and over again, everyone wants their dog to be a little bit protective in case someone breaks in the house. And I'm like, nope, it's going to be Amazon. Like, I would love to know, like, how many bites on Amazon delivery people there's been since Amazon, like, really got big.
Yeah. And now they're like going in people's houses.
Yes. I'd love to know what the numbers are.
Yeah.
They've got to be astronomical. Mm-hmm. So what I would do is on the remote collar, dogs leash reactive. What you can do is start from inside the house. And if your dog explodes at the front door, if your dog explodes out the front window, you have to go potty. Okay, go ahead. No, wait. Well, I don't want you pissing on the floor right here. It's worse than a goat. Okay. So you would correct the dog for that. Outside, we'll focus on a really, really good heel and then work on the spatial pressure video and get the dog behind you in follow mode. That lowers the arousal of the dog. And then also, yes, when you sign to apply a correction or a punisher, it's always the first sign. For everybody watching on Facebook Live, thank you so much. YouTube Live, thank you. And then on Spotify, our iHeartRadio. And so many of the other platforms. Thank you all so much. Next.
Kathy B said dog parks are to be avoided like the plague. Only good for training my reactive dog to not react when we're next to a dog park.
The outskirts of a dog park, yes.
Rochelle, thank you for the response. Do you have info on raw feeding to direct me to?
Actually, we have an ebook on our website. I mean, there's free resources online as well. But if you go to solidcaninetraining.com in the shopping cart, it's an ebook. It's really, really fantastic. And you can download that. Next.
Kathy, does the breed of the dog matter in training?
Well, it depends on what kind of training you're talking about. So I'm a pet dog trainer. So I'm a family pet dog. Do you have enough room there?
Yeah, okay. I had my elbow on here, and then you moved, so
okay.
It threw me off.
Okay. So I'm a family pet dog trainer. So for us, no, it doesn't matter at all. It's because I don't do sport, or I don't do agility, or I don't do, you know, anything like that, you know, search and rescue or whatnot. So as a family pet dog trainer, all my advice is pretty wide stroke across the board. Next.
Melissa posted the link to a one-on-one consult with you.
Awesome.
Gretchen said, I left my job. You were right. It was toxic.
Good for you, Gretchen.
Ivanka, hi. We have a 3-month German Shepherd. We just got a prong collar. Should we use it all the time or just outside?
Well, it's 12 weeks old. It might be a little bit early to use it. Right now, you should be doing a ton of food and marker training. Use a clicker if you want to use that as your yes marker. A ton of it. Feed it like, you know, dozens of a day. Dozens of repetitions of sit, down, place. Dozens of recall, get it used to leash pressure. But when you start doing training, a training tool is a training tool. You'd be using it whenever you were training. Next.
Kathy, or is the training the same no matter the breed?
Breed doesn't matter as, I think, how do I say this? The ability to learn or genetics has a lot to do with it. The drive in the dog. The motivation of the dog, the temperament, but breed doesn't matter as much. I mean, we get high drive, name the breed, and then we get low drive, name the breed.
German Shepherds that have literally no toy drive.
I know. So I think it's more about like being a pet dog trainer and getting dogs that are not like bred for a specific, like a working, like they'd be washed if they get made it up into a program, you know? Mm-hmm. We have to deal with what we have to deal with. So breed doesn't really as matter as much.
JG, I was looking for your spatial pressure video and can't find it. Is DIY 2020 still available?
Yes, and it's on our Patreon page. You have to join Patreon, the $10 level, to access it. Next.
Ilona, how would I get my dog to come?
Just a little bit of that. You know?
I knew you were going to say something stupid.
I mean, a little bit of that too, but I didn't do that. That would have gotten me really hit.
That's
right?
Disgusting.
Okay. So watch the How to Make Your Dog Come video. It's not on Pornhub. It's actually on Solid Canine Training. So watch that video.
It's called Recall.
Recall Training. And not just our Recall Training video. There's tons of Recall Training videos out there. It's a formal training exercise like sit, down, place. Going in a crate, anything else, it's a formal exercise. Next.
Garcia family, when would you neuter?
I personally would not. So that becomes now family choice. Next.
Ilona, I already read that. Gabriel, hey, Jeff and Joel.
Hey, Gabe. How are you, Gabe? How's things in Hawaii, the island that we can't get on? I know. Next.
We got bumped, as always. Kara. The Dane is 4 unaltered. I have tried popping away from me, but he refuses. It does seem that he is confused, and that's why he's lashing out. I'll try with a long line once I have the muzzle.
Yeah, so it's not a way. He could be confused. I mean, it's a lot of pressure on a dog. The first thing you can try to do is get the dog to stand up and move, you know. But chances are what we see all the time, that maybe not necessarily your dog, but we see this all the time, is big dogs use their girth to object. Mm-hmm. And they're like, you ain't gonna move me. So what do you teach the dog to do? Oh, I'll move you. Next.
Danny, hi guys. Should I bonk my dog when he's whining at the back door? He does not need the toilet and just turns around and looks at me when I do let him out. Also, is it okay to bonk him if he's looking right at me when I say no? Or should I take him by surprise only when he's not expecting the correction? Thanks in advance.
So there's a couple of different factors here. Number one, you always say no first and then you deploy your punisher. Just like you say yes first and you deploy your reward. It's common. That's how dog training exists. It's like mark the behavior and then either reward or correct. When it comes to bonking, if you don't know what a bonker is, it's a rolled up cotton towel. It does not cause brain damage and your head will not cave in with your eyeballs popping out. It's the farthest thing from abuse there is. Okay. If you think barking is abuse, you really need to re-educate yourself. All right. Your dog biting your child is abusive. So it's okay to, ideally depends on what the protocol is, but by surprise is always effective. But a lot of times, once you start working with your dog and you say no, it looks up at you. Now, the problem is at the beginning of your training journey or your rehab journey, you have to follow through with something. So even though the dog is looking at you, you still have to bark. And I assure you, you will not ruin the relationship. I can't stress that enough. I mean, I've had it when I took the cell phone away from one of my teenagers, like she probably would have rather been bonked. And it's like, guess what? I walked up to her, I reached out my hand, and I said, give me your cell phone. She handed it to me. She knew she was giving it to me. I didn't sneak into a room at night and steal it and go, oh, I don't know where it is. Mm-hmm. You know what I mean? It's like, no, I'm taking this from you. I'm applying your punisher. It's okay. If anything, it's probably more effective in that context. Next.
Ryan, my dog is very reactive when he sees another person or dog. When I correct him, he sometimes stops being reactive, but sometimes he gets more reactive. So what do I do?
Probably not being consistent enough, and you're probably underwhelming your dog. And you also, excuse me, your timing might be off. Next. Meaning you're correcting too late. Next.
Melissa posted the link to Patreon for the DIY playlist.
Thank you, Melissa.
She also posted the link to our raw feeding book on our website.
Thank you,
Cheryl. So when I go back to work, I'll be gone 13 hours for 3 days a week. I do have someone coming in halfway through to let her out to go to the bathroom. But that person tends to cause a lot of excitement and does not seem to want to take part in her training. And since I do not have any other options, I'm wondering if it would be better to not have someone come in. I'm just worried that 13 hours is too long. Where she is already a nervous and anxious dog, I'm worried I will set her back.
So this is it. It's like the lesser of two evils here. So 13 hours is definitely too long. You need somebody to come in midway and let the dog out. Now, the person that's helping you out, hopefully it's an adult. Hopefully there is a level of maturity. And if you're paying them for a service, so it's not like it's just a friend or relative letting them out, but even if it was, sit them down, have a rational, mature conversation with them and saying, and like role play it, saying, this is the way I would like my dog to be let out. The problem is you are not meeting their happiness needs, the human's happiness needs. So they will take offense to it. That's the problem. That's why this person is resistant to doing it, because you're taking away their happiness. And they don't want that. But it's for the best thing for the dog. If you truly care about the dog, you will follow these protocols. Next.
Cam, several Q&As ago, you said my dog is a dick based on her behavior. And I 100% agree and want to fix it. How do I correct her? Constant vocal corrections, teeth showing toward two dogs she now has to live with. I, again, have no issue with her never becoming best buds with them, but I need her to take it down a notch. She's worse with me present, and I'm afraid I'll make the problem worse without a proper approach. She is in no way dog aggressive, just thinks she is too good to allow another dog.
Okay, so stop right there. Your dog does not think it's too good. Don't even go there. Who said that? What's her name? So I can yell at her properly.
Cam,
don't you dare humanize your potentially aggressive dog. The dog is resource guarding you. What starts out as a growl, actually what starts out as this, what starts out as, okay, Bert. You call Bert over to pet Bert. Wes, which is her other dog, comes over and tries to get in between them. That's how, like, dog fights start. That's how a dog starts guarding her. First from a dog, then from maybe children, then from maybe people, then from maybe your spouse. So what you do is the dog showing its teeth, no, correct. Next.
Lauren, LOL, it was the Amazon guy that he bit. Great guess.
Yeah. I'm telling you. I sort of know what I'm talking about here, guys. Next.
Ryan, whenever we walk in public, he's okay. But whenever someone gets close, he will get very reactive.
So what you want to do is, yep, you've got to just start role-playing that. Role-play it. Do the spatial pressure exercise. Do my driveway drills. So watch my spatial pressure exercise video, my driveway drills exercise video, and then also get to a little bit better timing on your information get delivered to the dog when they start at the first signs of getting reactive. Next.
Chelsea, we rescued a pit about a week ago. He is 4 years old. He'll walk into his kennel, but before even locking it, turns around, barks, growls, shows teeth. He sounds like a maniac. Yep. He also does this with food.
Yep.
I get scared because he looks right into our eyes and growls. Yep. Otherwise, he is so loving. How do I fix this? He does not like, I'm sorry.
Okay.
He does not like treats. I don't know why. So I'm not sure how to reward him for his good behavior. I look forward to a one-on-one with you, but I wanted to shoot some questions in the meantime. Okay.
So Chelsea, Ted Bundy.
I knew you
was a great conversationalist.
That's why I laughed, because I knew once I said that he is so loving.
Okay. He's not so fucking loving. He's trying to take your fucking head off. He's not loving. He's loving when he wants to be loving, and he's meeting some of your emotional needs, but he's being a major asshole, and he's being a dangerous one at that. So get yourself a remote collar. And I'm telling you, so many people will disagree with this, and I'm blown away by it, but that's what leaves owners struggling and dogs surrendered, and dogs end up dead. Literally, dogs are killed for this.
Oh, yeah.
So, and we see this all the time.
Mm-hmm.
Kennel up, close the latch, dog goes for our hand. No, correct. Hi. Yep. Light him up, Gellman. Strikes again. Are you serious? You just went for my hand? Around the food. It's called resource guarding. Teach your dog the out command. I've got a free video on that. Now, you're going to hear a couple of things that'll destroy the relationship. No, it won't. Your dog's got a foot in the grave.
She only had him for a week anyway.
Okay. Number two, the dog will hate the crate. No, it won't. Do you think that anybody that tells me that, oh, my dog goes in the crate, lies down, and go to sleep, I would suggest this protocol? If you went to close the latch and your dog licked your finger, I find that annoying. So I probably, but you think I would suggest this protocol? No. All of my protocols are based on the dog's behavior when it comes to applying a punisher. Like, I'm still blown away to this day that people like have a hard time with this correction concept. It's like, should we just be allowing dogs to be biting us with no consequence? Biting our children with no consequence? And forget the fucking treats, because you don't need any for this. You can do food training on other things, but on this, it's correction-based. Next.
Gabriel said, Jeff, your jokes are great.
Who's making jokes?
I don't know. You talking about...
I haven't made a joke.
You made some dirty-ass jokes, and I'm so glad I just stopped myself from saying what I was going to say. Tiffany, for a new to us, because I'm not a vulgar person.
You? Are you fucking kidding me?
On camera.
Thank you for that little disclaimer, asterisk. You've had your moments on camera.
No.
Oh, my.
Tiffany.
Joel.
Me? No.
Joel.
G-rated all the
time. I bet you I can get... A track put together of Joelle's greatest vulgar moments.
I doubt it. Tiffany, for a new to us 3-year leash reactive pit bull from a shelter, would you use no leash pressure then the towel bonker, or no leash pressure then e-collar? Is that the correct order, or is the no in leash pressure simultaneously?
Okay. It's always no first, no matter what, because that marks what you don't like. And then you can do no, and then you bonk, or you can do no, and then remote collar. Next.
Kathy, I'm signing up for the Illinois workshop. See you in October. Need a little extra help with our overexcited Akita. Want to learn the calm on command.
Your dog, you will learn calm on command. I'll see you in Chi-Town.
CT Vader, I was walking the dogs the other day, and another dog walker approaches me with his dog going crazy. My dog keeps walking with no nonsense. Thank you for all you teach.
You're welcome.
Kara.
Maybe that was his shtick.
Shtick?
like the other dog walker shtick.
Oh, look at my crazy ass dog.
Yeah, it's like, I'll take your dog and like teach it how to be crazy on the walk. It's like one of those restaurants where you go into and the waiters or waitresses are rude to you on purpose. Like that's their thing. It's like
Dick's Last Resort.
Yeah. Next.
They write funny shit on your hat.
Okay.
Kara, I'm usually alone when I train dogs. Could I maybe put a long line around a tree and pull the dog away that
way? Yes, you could. Yep.
Oh my God, if I get bumped one more time tonight, I just can't.
See, that was X-rated right there.
Cheryl, yes, it is my mother coming in and it is being done for free, but she tends to get nervous to correct Bella.
Okay. Well, fine. Don't correct the dog, but stop enabling the dog. Next.
Ivanka says, thank you.
You're welcome.
Kenneth, I'm fostering a 10-year-old male fixed beagle for a family member for a month while they recover from hip surgery. The dog hasn't been around other dogs and kids. Why are you looking at me?
I look at you probably 100 times a show. Usually that seemed like
intentional. You're very like, what was that for? Because hip surgery? Are you implying something?
No, I actually look at you all the time. When you're okay. Almost every single question you ask, my head is facing you.
The dog hasn't been around other
kids. Should I be looking at my watch
dogs
instead?
Dogs and kids. Knows no commands, so teaching it kennel in place right off the bat. Best awesome. Advice on first meeting.
So, who's it meeting?
His kids.
Oh, his kids? It's for a month? There's no reason why he has to meet the kids. So, just do obedience training and kennel him up. I don't know if he's a friendly dog or not. If he's a non-friendly dog towards kids, I would just be, it's only a month. He doesn't meet your kids. Put him in a crate. Is that the final answer? No, but he's not your dog and you're helping out a friend. And the last thing you need to do is get your kids bit. Next.
Gretchen, I saw an article a while back about a woman who decided to put down her aggressive dog who refused to allow anything she did to make any progress. She was heartbroken to put him down and compared it to an abusive relationship and got bashed online for murdering her dog. The people pretending they were in the same situation, so they felt like their criticism was valid.
Yeah, everybody's a fucking expert, but the problem is nobody walks in that person's shoes. I've got a lot of empathy for people that have to make hard decisions. You know, could she have done more? Possibly, but you know what I mean? It's like, until you walk into someone's shoes, you really should keep your fucking mouth shut. And even if you do walk in someone's shoes, and if you say someone bad, you should still keep your fucking mouth shut because now you're just rude. Next.
Kara, for the separation anxiety from the other Dane, I can't move his crate out of the room he's in, so I've covered part of the cage with a blanket so he can't see the other dog. I correct dog when I know he's starting to escalate into whining and drooling, when I walk toward other dog's cage to remove her from the room. Been leaving him in the kennel alone a lot, doing downstays while I worked the other day, doing place in different areas of the house. Any other tips? Been addressing this for about a week.
So, I mean, it's only been a week. It's not, you know, you should have seen a little bit of progress just by like putting protocols in place. You see progress. And we do that all the time. It's like first couple of days, we just do some structure. First day, we just do some structure. And the dogs are incredibly different. First week, they're incredibly different just by, and they don't even know really truly any obedience commands to like any level of quality yet. I think you got a really, really good start, but if you've got two Great Danes and you're struggling and one of them might be aggressive, I'd think about a one-on-one counsel. And I'm not trying to drum up one-on-one counsels here, but I want you to make sure that you get complete answers. It's so hard to get complete answers, but it sounds like a lot of the things you're doing are like, was what I would suggest. Next.
JP, Jeff, best way to correct a dog who barks when he hears someone using a fly swatter in any room?
Just put a bark collar on the dog or a remote collar, just a remote collar, and then get a fly swatter and start swatting shit. And, you know, and then desensitize the dogs. I feel
like that's something Wes would totally like. He would think that's a game. I've never actually done that in front of him.
Absolutely.
He would totally chase it.
Well, he'd probably want to know where the fly was.
Yeah, there's, you know, those ones by the front door.
Yes.
Now we can't go out the freaking front door without him pouncing on it, trying to chase it.
Are you serious?
Yes. It's been there for like three days.
You just went out the front door.
Yeah, and he made a little side trail to try to chase the fly.
What do you mean a side trail? Like which way?
Into the corner. He's like
inside the building?
Yes. Before we can get outside, he's like trying to attack the stupid fly. I'm like, and the door is open and the fly won't go outside. I'm like,
that's a stupid ass fly.
It's so dumb. It deserves to.
If you're gonna, fucking die, because flies don't live long.
No.
If you're gonna die, why wouldn't you want to die outside in nature? Why would you want to fucking go in the dumpster and
die? It's like, just go outside. I'm holding the door open. It's just like in the corner.
The dumpsters, go in the dumpster. Die on a fucking piece of food.
Anywhere.
Or that's where we put the dog poop. Die on a piece of dog poop. You want to talk about heaven? That's heaven.
Yeah. It just goes up and down, up and down.
That's heaven.
Dumbass thing. Next. Lucy, what's the best way to introduce my dog to other dogs? She used to be reactive and show aggression toward other dogs, so I used an e-collar to correct her, but now she often avoids them.
Good.
How can I teach her good socialization skills? How do you teach the out command?
So there's two different things there. The out command, watch our video. I've got a free video on how to out away from an object and how to out away from people. But the one that's out away from people, you can also use it for out away from dogs. As far as how to introduce your dog to another dog, I don't know because, I mean, I do know. I know very, very well. But I don't know your dog. I don't know the other dogs. And I don't know your skill set. I don't know your tone of voice you're going to use. I don't know your timing. I don't know the tools you have. I don't know your experience. So it would be a disservice for me to tell you. All I can say is work on migration and work on existence first, or being around each other, and then we take it from there. Next.
Laura, you should definitely make a track of Joelle's best vulgar moments. I bet it would be a hit.
I could. A laugh track is easy. That'd be easy to do.
But again, you should make one for you too. Would definitely get a lot of views. LOL. Love you guys. Oh, and I've been able to get my GSC to do a double down finally.
Nice. Congratulations. Next.
JP, what's the backstory of the puppet behind you? Honestly, JP, I can't believe you haven't asked about freaking Danny DeVito back here. You notice he's a puppet on the wall, but what about Danny? Scary Danny.
So I got that puppet in Las Vegas at...
That thing's kind of scary, too.
Because at one point I was going to make these kid videos, like how to teach kids how to be around dogs, and I was going to use the puppet like as like the mouthpiece of the video. That was the goal. Next.
Like some Sesame Street shit?
Yeah, some Sesame Street shit.
Gabriel, I worked with an aggressive bull terrier. Definitely a whole nother level of training. Very stubborn dog, but the outcome was good. It's nice when you have a client that listens to you.
No, it's everything. It's everything when you have a client that listens to you. Yes.
Speaking of, Becky, our superstar client.
Hey, Becky, love you.
Hey, guys, working with Hops outside in place while we work in the yard to expose her to distractions. I mow the grass around her, and she's fearful of the lawnmower. So she moves off place when I get close. When she's not tied up, I tell her out when she's near the mower because we don't want her near it.
No.
If she breaks place around the mower, is this okay since we don't want her around the mower? Or should we expect her to stay with it near? Thanks.
Expect her to stay with it near because you're not going to run her over. And you're correcting her for not being afraid. You're correcting her for breaking a known command. Next.
Netra, slip lead or prong?
As far as do it for what? If I'm taking dogs out to go to the bathroom, I put a slip lead on them. Training, a prong collar. Two different things. That's like saying walking or taking a car. You'll both get there. Two totally different things. Prong collar is probably one of the best training tools for your average pet owner, even pet dog trainer, to help empower them to communicate the training. Next.
B-Rips, how to stop a dog resource guarding their humans from other dogs.
I've got a video on the out command, out away from humans. Next.
Kara, my dog makes side trips too. LOL, sometimes I'll send her to place and she makes a quick stop by the toy basket and grabs a toy and brings it with her to the bed.
So I'd correct that, believe it or not. Some people won't. Some people don't care. What's the big deal? Well, could be a big deal. Next.
Tracy, use bonker to stop dog chasing the cat and then let the cat manage her own personal space. That helped. Dog now appears fearful of the cat. Good. Won't stop staring and whining. Should I use a bonker for fear response?
No, you're using the bonker for staring and whining. Right? I don't mind if my dog, like, I made my dogs afraid of my cat.
That doesn't sound like fear, though. That just sounds like anxiety, right, like exactly. Anticipation.
Anticipation. Like, yeah, I would.
There's the cat.
Yeah. Oh, my God. I want to break command and like, attack it. So I would. So, again, I'd correct that. Next.
JP, I can't disrespect Danny DeVito like that. No. We play Don't Ask, Don't Tell with Danny DeVito.
It's so true.
He's just back there, like. Why?
I got two of them.
Two of them. Like, nobody has said anything about it. They're just like, yep, no big deal. Freaking Danny DeVito sparkling on the couch. Sparkling face. Gretchen said, LOL, say Sesame Street shit 10 times fast.
Won't do it.
Sesame
next.
Street shit. That's easy. That's not a tongue twister. JP.
You said it once, though.
So with the remote caller, simple as making it suck when he barks at fly swatter usage.
Yep, exactly.
JP, the way you say stuff, I can't. It's funny. Who is that comedian on that show? That guy's funny.
I don't know. I'm going to watch another episode tonight, I think, though.
I was crying. Next. Amber, how do you get your dog to stop barking on command?
Teach it no.
N-O.
Teach it no and put value behind no. Remote collar is going to be the most efficient. No, correct. Next.
Kara, you should definitely make a kids around dogs video. Just recently deleted a friend from Facebook because she thinks it's cute to let his kid climb all over their dog and slam a toy in the dog's face over and over.
Yep.
Didn't believe me when I told him the dog was showing body language that he's going to bite.
Even if he wasn't showing body language he's going to bite, he's eventually going to bite. That kid will have no face. So I would actually give them a phone call. If it's a true friend, not just like a fake Facebook friend, but if it's someone you actually know, I would actually call them up and say, you really should stop doing that. And don't get into scientific, like your dog's body language. Just say, your dog will bite your kid. Fact. Just say that. Don't get into the like lick lipping, you know, whale eyes, you know, the dog's body language out of it. Don't get into any of that conversation. Just stick to the basics. Stick to the basics. Your dog's going to bite your kid. Next.
It's a tough one though.
Not for me.
I know, but I feel like people like literally argue and hate each other over this.
She's already defriended her.
I know.
You got nothing to lose. And guess what? It could save the kid's life.
Yeah.
And the dog's life. So to me, that's worth it. It is absolutely worth it.
Yep. Agreed.
God forbid. 100%. God forbid nobody says something to that. Now, if I see stuff online all the time, people send me stuff.
Well,
now,
I think she did say something. I didn't believe me. So right.
Because you were too scientific about it. Make it simpler. Next.
Ashley G. Hi, Jeff. Hi, Joelle. I've missed you guys. Glad to finally catch another
one. Oh, miss you too, Ashley.
Tracy said, thank you.
You're welcome.
Truck driver dog guy. I thought Danny was just a chubby-faced Jeff. They do not look alike at all. Come on. Gretchen said, laugh my ass off, Nathan. Gretchen, don't enable him.
Yep, don't worry about it.
JP, did Confidence Room video ever come out? I've been out of the loop for a while.
We've taken videos in the Confidence Room. Angela did a tour of it a while ago.
Yeah. I don't think we've made an official
video. You know what? It might be on Angela's Instagram page. Hmm. Yeah, check out at Angelo Gellman.
No, I think that was Instagram. Alive. That was a Facebook
live. Ooh, that was that alive. That was. That's gone. Maybe you'll make another one soon.
Amber said, thank you.
You're welcome.
JP, for me, because of quarantine, I forgot how to socialize around people. I need to start from step one for myself.
Yeah, it's true. It's true. I had to go into Walgreens yesterday to get some supplies. And I sort of like grabbed my mask, put it on, walked in, did my thing, paid, walked out. I'm like, okay.
I definitely talk less when I have my mask on.
You know, but I was just like, okay.
It's interesting how that works.
But I was just like, okay, I get it. Like, yep, I got to run an errand. And then you know what else I thought about? I thought about, you know, well, first of all, a lot of stores are closed. But I thought about how many people are not going into stores or not running as many errands because of that small inconvenience.
100%. Today,
you actually have to think about it.
Today, I was going to stop at Seven Stars.
Think about that.
To get a coffee.
Yep.
And I'm like, I don't want to put a mask on.
Right.
Went to Starbucks drive-thru instead.
No, seriously. Think about it, though.
Yeah.
And you cannot be the only one.
Especially if I'm wearing a hat because I got to take my hat off.
Right.
Put my mask on.
Yeah, I know. It's a whole procedure for you.
Like not worth it.
Right. I mean, just think about little things like that and multiply that times
multiple times a day.
100 people a day, and that is money, cash flow that business.
There's been times where I'm like, oh, I gotta go to Walgreens, and I'm like, fuck it, I'll order it on Amazon.
Yeah.
What's two more days?
Yep, exactly. Just think about that. Next.
Yep. Dory, glad I've caught another live tonight.
Awesome.
Kathy said, what is the confidence room?
We have a room that's built to increase confidence in dogs. And we've got a Tony Robbins 24-hour video tape running next.
Gretchen. Oh, wait. $18 top chat from Hannah. How do you convince a long-legged dog that hardwood floors can cause expensive accidents? Yoda is looking a lot like Bambi on ice.
So, yeah, I know. The loser is like, didn't you know how to walk? I thought you knew how to walk. What you do is you heal them slowly through the room, and you get make sure their nails are cut short, and make sure they don't splay out. But that can be hard for some dogs because they splay out. Next,
Gretchen said you can also go back to your story archives with IG. Maybe Facebook does that too.
Yes,
it wasn't a story that was alive.
Yes,
Garcia family sucks not to respond to smiles.
Yeah, I know. I know. That's why I'm probably saying hello more.
Yeah.
You know, but it is what it is. Next.
JP, I'm the same way. I'm all about convenience right now.
I think everybody is. I think, you know, it's sort of like back in the day. I'm like, yeah, but we're not back in the day.
Right.
We've been programmed.
We're supposed to be getting more progressive.
So, but also we've been programmed to do this. Yes, we'll make, I mean, trust me, we've all made life changes.
Yeah.
Everybody has, but you can't blame someone for like having a hard time with it as well, because it's like you've been conditioned.
Mm-hmm.
No, I've been conditioned. Today I ordered three things on Amazon. Yesterday I ordered three things on Amazon. Like, we get shipments in from Amazon every day. And by the way, none of our dogs bite the delivery person. So we get different deliveries in from Amazon every day. So it's just like, you know, I remember opening up a box and there's a roll of duct tape. And then I remember
I will order the most random stuff.
I remember opening up a box and there was a thing of Windex spray. I'm like, what the fuck? Like, guys.
I don't want to go to the store.
I know.
Nope. Laura, I think that's a great idea to make videos to help teach kids to understand how to be around dogs.
Yep.
I first started following you guys when my GSD snapped at my 4-year-old back in February when they were playing with pretzels with my dog, which ended up in a trip to the ER. It was a snap to the face. I understand that it was my fault with not teaching the kids how to interact with the dog and with needing better training when it comes to my dog. It was a very difficult experience, and I would only, I don't know where the rest is.
Right. But. So number one, so who asked that question?
Laura.
So Laura, number one, thank you so much for admitting that it was your fault, because it was. And thank you for being humble enough to admit that. And then now you know, and now you know what to do, you know, moving forward. Next.
Pulsar dog training. I did get into the body language conversation. Yeah. They told me I'm a joke because I'm scared of all dogs and I don't trust them for someone who claims to train them. Asses. Hope I'm wrong and it never happens.
Yeah. Yeah. Hey, you did. You spoke your mind. I would have definitely not made it scientific, but either way, even though you did, you still spoke their mind. The child will unfortunately pay the price, and so will the dog. Next.
JP, the only good thing about the mask is it hides my half-assed mustache that grows in.
You can shave that off, and then it's a non-ass mustache. Next.
No mustache.
Yep.
JP, yeah, Jeff, I'm getting in deliveries every day now, ordering random stuff.
Well, I'm not ordering random stuff. I'm ordering necessity stuff. If anything, I think I've done a better job.
Order my vitamins now. I'm like,
yeah, but still, don't you think since COVID started, you've done a better job at like realizing, do you need this or do you not need this?
Oh yeah, definitely.
You know what I mean? Just for cash flow, just for your personal budgeting. Mm-hmm. I think I've definitely, even though your revenue has actually gone up because of your own side business, I think this has made me, well, me especially, realize it's like, you know what? I really don't need this. I really don't need this.
I even changed my car insurance and saved $100 a month.
Nice. I'm amazed.
I know. I was getting ripped
when
off.
When you said $100, I thought that was like, I thought it was like a year. I'm like, a month? Holy effing shit.
I was getting ripped
off. Well, here, I'll tell you a story right now. In one of our houses in Florida, if we put hurricane something on, it's this L-shaped bracket on the roof around the roof that secures the roof to the frame, I'll save about $2,500 a year on homeowners insurance because it secures the roof more if a hurricane comes through.
Interesting.
Yeah. Next.
Gretchen, Jeff, what are your thoughts on dogs licking people's faces? I mean, I tolerate a lot, but I do draw the line at the
face. I think it's disgusting.
I think it's disgusting.
I think it's gross.
Truck driver dog guy. I didn't mean to say Jeff was chubby. I honestly thought it was a really bad screen print of Jeff's face. I couldn't imagine why a person wanted a fade pillow.
So I don't mind
face pillow.
A face pillow. I don't mind anybody, you know, making comments about my physical appearance. So I didn't take it personally.
JP, Jeff, I've never used an e-collar. Could I purchase a Skype session? I've got a wireless mic and a pretty good camera to put on a tripod, so you could assist me with using it, or is it not too hard?
No. Well, both. It comes with an owner's manual. There's a lot of free videos on there, but I've trained many people how to remote collar train their dogs by, we actually use StreamYard. We actually use the same software program that we've got right now. Like, we'll do it on the same software program, and instead of it being a single screen of just me, I can make you bigger, or I can make, I just rub the screen a little bit, or I can, you know, do a split screen. Now, why did you hit me?
I just rubbed the screen a little bit.
Why did you hit me, though?
Like, what was that supposed to
mean? Why are you harming me?
Because that was not a necessary comment.
What? Next.
JP, holy shit. Yeah, Jeff, facts. I make more food now because I don't need to go out. If I don't need to go out, I really won't. So I just go to the bulk stores and stock up.
Yeah. You, what's one good thing about you, though, Joel, is, well, one of the many good qualities about you, but one good thing, I mean, you're consistent with your meals.
Yeah.
But I think with my meals, I'm becoming extremely consistent. I think I've always sort of done this, but I'm like, you know, it's like I cook off a bunch of rice, I cook off a bunch of vegetables, I cook off a bunch of protein, and I'm like, and then I've got my salads, and I'm just like, yep, I'm just going to mix it together tonight and eat. And I'll just do that every day.
I literally do not miss.
Yeah, eating out, I don't. Really. I don't really have a selection.
No.
No. We stopped at a restaurant a couple weeks ago that was really good, though.
We did.
Yeah, the guy with we talked told the story about the guy with the small.
Oh yeah.
That was really good. Next.
Jennifer said, "So gross, face licking."
Yeah.
JP, cool. I'll check that out. I'll have my AirPods in so I could hear you real time.
Nice.
Nick. Another dog trainer put me on to you guys, and I haven't looked back. Bonker is a game changer. Thanks.
Awesome.
Game changer.
Thank you, Nick.
Interesting.
Is that next? Is that all? Is that over?
That's it.
Really?
It's 7:56. Well, you didn't go on any rants tonight.
No.
No.
Just made a couple of inappropriate comments.
Yep.
According to you.
I don't know why my wrist hurts right here, like where my watch has been sitting all day.
When you work out, is there a bend right there, like doing this position?
I think it's just been rubbing weird. Hurts.
Nice. So,
JP, oh, wait, hold on. Michael, is it normal for dogs to be hyper after a few rainy days?
I mean, if you didn't exercise them, maybe.
Crazies are coming.
Maybe. Out. I don't know. It doesn't sound like normal Angela going to the bathroom noise.
JP said, how is Pokemon going for Angelo?
Angelo.
Smash Brothers.
Angelo, come here. You're going to take up the last 3 minutes of this show.
Why?
Because. JP's got some questions for you. JP wants to know how Pokemon's going for you.
It's going okay.
That's it?
That's it?
What are you playing now? How about Smash Brothers?
Kid doesn't stop talking about it until he's on camera.
How about Smash Brothers? He wants to know about goes in Smash Brothers. How's Smash Brothers going?
I don't play it that much. I usually just play Minecraft at home.
What are you playing right now, though?
I'm watching YouTube.
Oh, what was that? No, what you had that little game system.
Oh, I was playing Splatoon 2.
Splatoon?
Yeah.
What's that?
It's pretty much this game where you play as some sort of squid mixed with a human, and you gotta fight enemies. It's pretty much just a fighting game, but with ink guns.
Really?
Yeah.
You want to do a podcast soon? Okay. We'll do a podcast.
Yeah, everyone's asking, when's Angela come back to the podcast?
That's what I asked you, Papa.
Okay, Angela was going to do a podcast this weekend.
Wait.
You'll do one this weekend sometime.
Back.
Angela, why does JP keep dying with Ivysaur in Smash Brothers?
Well, it depends what Pokemon
you're fighting. Come a little bit closer.
It depends what Pokemon you're fighting, or the Pokemon's level, and maybe the moves.
Mm. So how should he prevent the character from dying?
I would try to level it up.
Talk to them.
Oh, I would try to maybe level it up. Let me think of another. That's the only way I could think of
it. He also said Splatoon is a good game.
Good.
I really like it.
All right. Thanks a lot, buddy. All right. See you later. All right, everybody. Thanks, guys. Madly in love with you. Thank you, Angelo, Joelle. Thank you for another fantastic show.
You're welcome.
Really, really appreciate you like going the extra mile. I know you're tired. I know these shows are like the last thing you want to be doing at 7 o'clock at night, especially after getting up so early, but I do appreciate it. So thank you so much. I just want you to know that I appreciate you. Hey, everybody. I appreciate all of you and thank you all so much and take care. And today is Friday. We'll see you all on Monday. You have a lot of content. You have a lot of content made, right?
Yeah, and I have a whole bunch of emails I got to go through from Faith.
So you're going to queue up some stuff this weekend.
Yeah.
Usually weekends are lighter. Are you going to go a little bit heavier this weekend, you think?
Probably, because I have a lot.
Okay.
I'm like, I had to email Faith. I'm like, listen, I haven't had time to sit down and download these yet, so don't
delete them.
I'm like, don't delete them.
Oh, that's right, because it takes up space. All right, guys. Take care. Bye-bye. Love you. Bye.